Have you ever been to a flea market or a neighborhood yard sale? You might see a variety of vendors with their own tables, selling all kinds of stuff. Everything from valuable antiques and vintage clothing to rare collectibles and used toys and books. It's usually a loud and vibrant place. There may be prices listed on some of the items, but everyone knows that they're not set in stone. It's up to the customers and the vendors to bargain and negotiate until they reach a price on which they can both agree. Now, this is not how most transactions take place in our economy, but it is a good representation of an economic concept called market equilibrium. It's all about finding the right prices at the right time to satisfy both the seller and the customer. By the end of today's lesson, you should be able to answer the following questions. What is market equilibrium, and how do you represent it graphically? What are the advantages of market equilibrium? How does market equilibrium change? And you should start thinking about our big picture question. How does market pricing work to balance the interests of consumers and producers? Before we go too far, go ahead and get your PDF ready. You're going to want to follow along with some of the graphs we'll be looking at in this lesson. Okay, let's return to that video game console from the previous lesson, Frostbite. Imagine that they've just released version 3.0. Let's take a look at the demand curve for the new version. Looks familiar, right? Note that the demand curve slopes downward as usual, meaning that the lower Frostbite prices their product, the higher the demand will be. This follows the law of demand. What about supply? How much is the company willing to produce at each price? Take a look at their supply curve. Note that it slopes upward as usual, following the law of supply. The higher the price, the more Frostbite would be willing to produce and sell. So, how do they set a price? What would maximize the benefit for both the consumer and the producer? Let's put these two points of view together. When you put the supply and demand curves together, what do you see? Where would you predict the price would naturally be set? If you guess that it would be the point at which the two curves intersect, you'd be right. This magic price is called market equilibrium. Market equilibrium is the point in the market where the amount of goods demanded by consumers is equal to the amount of goods a producer is willing to sell. So, where will Frostbite likely set the price for their new 3.0 console? That's right, at the point of equilibrium. Let's take a moment to review. Remember Jamie and his food truck? Let's take a look at how he sets his prices for hamburgers. In the PDF, you can see the supply and demand curves for burgers. Where should he set his price? Why? It kind of just makes sense that you would want supply to equal demand, right? But let's dig in a bit and see why market equilibrium has so many advantages. The first advantage is price stability. When supply and demand are in balance, prices are less likely to experience sudden and drastic changes. This stability allows consumers to plan their purchases and budget effectively. For producers, it makes it much easier to make decisions, plan their production, and invest wisely. Next, market equilibrium helps prevent excess supply and excess demand. What does that mean? Excess supply is called a surplus. That's when producers make too much of something and can't sell it. Obviously, that's not ideal. Frostbite does not want a warehouse full of unsold consoles generating zero revenue. What about excess demand? Economists call this a shortage. That's when there's not enough of a good or service to meet the demand for it. That creates unhappy customers and missed opportunities for the producer to increase profit. In the case of Frostbite 3.0, a shortage would mean that there were customers out there who were willing and able to buy a console, but there weren't enough to go around. In the worst case scenario for customers, shortages can lead to price gouging when sellers take advantage of that excess demand and try to jack up the prices to unreasonable levels. Finally, market equilibrium leads to efficient resource allocation. Avoiding a surplus means that resources can be put to their best use and not wasted on products that can't be sold. Plus, it maximizes efficiency and reduces unnecessary costs. What happens when the market is in disequilibrium? Basically, all of the bad things we just avoided. You can see price instability, surpluses or shortages, or waste and inefficiency. When the market is out of balance, either with a shortage or surplus, it also becomes tough for new producers to enter. During a shortage, resources become limited, initial costs rise, and the market may already be crowded. On the other hand, during a surplus, price competition intensifies, existing customers remain loyal to their brands, and market demand may be insufficient for more products to enter the scene. So, it's crucial for new entrants to carefully assess market conditions before diving in and facing these barriers head on. Let's take a moment to review. Jamie is not convinced that the equilibrium price would be best for him. After all, it looks like he'd make more money if he raised the prices higher. Choose the one advantage that you think would be most persuasive to him. How would you explain it? Imagine a scenario where blueberries become scarce due to a sudden freeze that damages crops. This event leads to a decrease in the supply of blueberries. As a result, the supply curve shifts to the left, indicating a lower quantity available at each price level. Now, with a reduced supply, the market equilibrium is disrupted. What happened to the equilibrium point on the graph now that the supply curve has shifted to the left? It moved, right? The equilibrium price has increased from $2.50 to $3. But why? With the decrease in supply, consumers still desire blueberries, but there isn't enough to meet their demand. As a response to the shortage, the price of blueberries may rise as sellers try to balance the limited supply and the high demand. On the other hand, let's consider a scenario where a technological advancement lowers the production costs of Frostbite 3.0. This leads to an increase in the supply of the consoles. As a result, the supply curve shifts to the right, indicating a higher quantity available at each price level. You can see that the market equilibrium is once again affected by this shift. What happened to the equilibrium price? It decreased to $200, right? What about the demand side of things? Can shifts in demand also affect the equilibrium price? Of course they can. Let's look at some examples. Remember those fidget spinners we talked about? Well, when they became a hot toy, demand surged, right? The demand curve shifted to the right, indicating that people were willing to buy more at every price point. What happened to the equilibrium price? That's right, it also shifted. It increased to $3 because as people were willing to buy more at a higher price, the producers were willing to sell more as well. But what if demand decreases? Let's say that a new competitor emerges and some of the customers go for this new substitute instead. The demand curve shifts to the left. What happens to the equilibrium price? That's right, it moves to a lower price of $2 to balance supply and demand. Understanding how shifts in supply and demand affect the equilibrium price helps us analyze market dynamics and predict the impact on both consumers and producers. Let's take a moment to review. Imagine that a famous celebrity chef came to town and made a viral video about Jamie's awesome food truck. How might that shift supply or demand? How would that affect the equilibrium price? Okay, let's review what we've learned. Equilibrium is the point in a market where the amount of goods demanded by consumers is equal to the amount of goods a producer is willing to sell. Market equilibrium benefits both consumers and producers in three ways. It creates price stability that allows both producers and consumers to better plan their purchases. It prevents excess supply, known as surplus, and it prevents excess demand, known as shortage. You can think of the equilibrium point as like Goldilocks finding her just right chair at the bear's house. Equilibrium also ensures that resources are allocated efficiently, which allows producers to maximize their profits. But we also talked about how the equilibrium point can move. Anytime the overall supply or demand curve increases or decreases, that equilibrium point will also shift. Just another reason why it benefits everyone to pay attention to what happens in the market. In our next lesson, we'll take a look at how competition can affect pricing as well, among other things. Until next time, this is Bea reminding you to keep investing in your future one lesson at a time. I'll see you next time. Hey, hey.